I've been teased about that Karen Crosser. She said, you know, Crosser, dirty double Crosser. That's all it is, just Crosser. One thing I have learned from working in India is that you must be flexible. If anybody asks me, I have to tell them. Now, if you can't be flexible, you just forget about going to India. Because you can go over there with all of your plans made, and probably before day one is over, something is going to have to change. Well, Ron and I had been in India for, well, we spend about 6 months a year there. I came home in October. This past October, I've been there about 4 or 5 months. Ron stayed for 7 more weeks, but I had to come home for a new grandbaby. I have 8, never missed the birth of one yet. 3 were born in India, 5 were born in Birmingham. But Ron came home in December. We immediately started making appointments for him to speak, to raise funds, to give reports about our work and what have you. And one of those appointments was at the Nassau Street Church right here in Tampa. And Sister Regina Atkinson and I began talking, and she said, would there be any way that you could come to Tampa and talk to the ladies about the work in India? We could have an all-day India day. Love it. So I got Ron's calendar out, and I said, he's going to be right back here in Tampa on May the 2nd. But let's put this off till May the 8th, and that way my children from India are here. We can spend the week going to whatever all the sites are here in Florida. And then on May 8th, we'll have an India Day for Women. Well, I went back to India. I got an email. Isn't an email wonderful? Mm-hmm. I got an email from Sister Regina, and she said, plans have changed. Flexibility. I can do this. She said she was visiting with her, contacting different ladies from different congregations here in Tampa, and found out that there was already something planned for this day. But they're going to work you in. I said, I can do that. So I told her, I said, I want to talk about living on the other side. What do you call that, a double connotation or whatever the word is? Living on the other side of the world and living on the other side as far as living in heaven. What we have to do today to be prepared to live in heaven. Well, then I found out the subject was on 1 Corinthians 13. I said, living on the other. I worked that in. No problem. Then I got an email from Linda. She said something about, am I my sister's keeper? And I thought, I can't work that in. So